DeMar.
What's up, bro?
Yo, what's good, baby?
What's up, man?
How you living?
I'm good.
I'm DJ.
DJ, the young boy. All right,
right.
What's up, man?
I'm a huge fan, bro.
All right, appreciate it.
Bro, what are you looking for?
I'm just trying to check out some shoes, man. You know, I'm...
Yeah, I feel you, man. I came for the new Kobe ADs, bro.
Okay, okay. Hope you got the Compton ones, but what's up?
Man, you should come by the crib. I got a full court. I'm working on a food court as well, man.
Okay.
And an aquarium. You got to come by, man.
All right, yeah.
And you should see my sneaker collection. It's out of this world.
I can do that for sure.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'll do that for sure, man. I'll check you out, bro. All
right, man. Nice to meet you, bro.
Yep, you too.
All I'm saying is, if you're going to tag me in photos on Facebook, don't do it with photos taken from a low angle where I look like a walrus.
Bri, is that mom?
It's my mom.
Tell her I say hi, man.
DJ says hi. Okay, no more low angles. Thank you. I love you, too. Bye. You, sir. Peep this.
Whoa. Oh, my God. Bri, this is crazy, man.
Crazy.
This needs to be a
insane
thing.
Insane. And it will be a thing. That will soon be on all your local supermarket shelves. And all you have to do is hit these performance benchmarks.
Yo, Brian,
we're
gonna be late.
What are you doing here?
Got the Fresh Letter show tonight, man.
Hold up, you have a show tonight? You didn't tell me?
Man, DJ, you way too judgy of the sketches,
man,
yo.
Your sketches are too broad. They're not sophisticated enough.
Yo, not everything's gotta be a metaphor. Make you think, man. Just go with it. Come on, you asking way too many questions.
You could be a little more supportive. That's it. Don't think about that. Think about this. She ruined my whole thing where I turned it around. Okay, look at that. Performance benchmarks. Hit those. Get that. Hit those. Get that.
These look doable, Bri, but I mean, how am I going to remember all these details?
Details, schmeetails. I will text you them.
All right.
Look on your phone. Welcome to the real world.
Thanks, man.
Have a good day. Oh, mother. Acceptable angle? Horrible. I am a warrior.
What is happening, Boss Nation? Welcome back to another NBA 2K18, my career. We're going to go ahead and continue with our regular season. Today, you guys saw in the beginning, we're meeting up with guys like DeMar DeRozan. He's actually at my house right now. Also, my agent said that there's a huge chance that I could be in front of a cereal box. So endorsements are sky high right now. Next on our plate, we have the Denver Nuggets. We're also going to be playing a game against the Phoenix Suns. So all that will be covered in this episode. You guys are seeing us third in the Western Conference. You got Golden State Warriors without a surprise. Number one, Houston Rockets. Number two, Denver Nuggets are number four. That's the team that we are playing on next. So it should be an interesting matchup. You guys know recently I became the starter of the team, getting 29 minutes per game. Check out this billboard. I mean, this starting five is unbelievable. Without wasting any time, let's go ahead and jump into this game. Your boy has been dunking now. The gameplay is going to go through the roof. And I'm guessing by the time the next episode happens, we should be close to the All-Star weekend. So I'm going to try my best to score as many points as possible, help my team win, and try to be in like most of these All-Star festivities. I want to be in the dunk contest. I want to be in the three-point contest. I want to take part in everything in my rookie season. Now, you guys saw me here in the first half. My goal was to get as many of my teammates as possible. I'm going to dish out assists. But once the second half starts, I'm going to take this game over. You guys see right here, once again, a bounce pass to Andrew Wiggins. He's knocking it down. And I don't know if you paid attention, but your boy right here is wearing Jordans. Now, I did not know this. I thought I was strictly signed to Nike. But you see me right here wearing Jordan 11s. How it happened was, in the beginning before the game starts, when you're in the closet, I said closet, I meant the locker room. When you're sitting in the locker room and, you know, the menu where you could change your accessories and all that, I went to my shoes and I see that I have Jordans in there as well. Now, I bought the Jordans from the Champ store in the neighborhood, but I didn't know that I could wear it in the NBA games. This whole time, I thought I was strictly signed to Nike, but I guess I could wear Jordans. Maybe I could wear any brand. Now, if this has negative effects, like if my contract, my Nike contract gets taken away, let me know. Like, have you guys done this before? Is this normal? Well, you guys see right here, as promised, I told you guys in the second half, I'm going to flip the switch and become more offensive. If you guys haven't liked this video already, make sure you do so. Also, subscribe if you haven't. We're getting so close to 900,000 subscribers. This game has been an absolute breeze, but why not? Let's go ahead and take a look. Another assist. Throwing an alley-oop to Taj Gibson. The Nuggets had no chance of coming back. 102-94 is the final score. Next up, we're taking on the Phoenix Suns.
What's up, D?
DJ, what's wrong, man?
Man, I can't take this anymore, man. The guys are putting me through the ringer. Sammy's got me over there wearing a kid's backpack, getting him loads of candy, donuts, cleaning his shoes. I mean, I can't take it anymore, bro.
Everybody has to do it, bro. You're a rookie.
It's ridiculous, man. How long, man?
Until the end of the season. You're going to be a rookie all year, so just get used to it, man. Do what they say. Don't give them a hard time.
Man, when I get my rookie, I'm never going to put him through what they put me through.
You say that now. We'll see.
All right, man. I'll see you out there.
All right, bro.
You know, the other day I was really thinking to myself, are the Timberwolves the team that I want to stay with? I always do it with all the careers that I do in NBA 2K. So I feel like it's only right to kind of talk things out with you guys with this year's 2K as well. Like, is Minnesota the team that I should finish out the year with and play year two with? Honestly, I'm not sure. I really don't know. I feel like it's too soon to be talking about stuff like this. But when I went up against a team like the Phoenix Suns, first of all, look at their statement jerseys. It made me regret my decision to begin with. Like, I should have went to them. Imagine me playing with Devin Booker, Alex Len, Jackson, their rookie. The list goes on. And on top of that, the jerseys that they have, just crispy clean. I don't know, man. I feel like it's too soon to be complaining or even be thinking about going to another team. But imagine me playing with Devin Booker. That would have been nasty. As you guys see him right here knocking out a three-point shot. I basically came back in the second half when we were down. So right now my goal is to obviously bring my team back. We're at the number three spot in the Western Conference. I'm trying to get us at least number two before the All-Star weekend. Told you guys, man, once I was able to figure out how my player can dunk, it will be over. An alley-oop right there earlier on, got a three-pointer go down. Basically, we are up by 9 points here, but the Phoenix Suns are fighting back. Here we go. This is a big possession right here, doing a step back. Oh, he doesn't want to step up. Look at the disrespect. He doesn't want to defend me up close. We're gonna make him pay for it. It's a 10-point game. Devin Booker, with 2 minutes left here, pulls up for a heavily contested three-point shot. Honestly, the clock is against them, and with them forcing shots like that, this game is about to be over very soon. Hold on. Let me call for an ISO and end this one. Moments later, my coach decided to take us out of the game. That's a really cool feature from this year. The fact that, like, when it's a blowout or, like, you know, when you know the game is over, your coach puts all the starters on the bench. And you guys see, like, the crowd has left the building. I really like the little details that they added this year. And that is it for the second game of the episode. Once again, we are victorious 108-95.
Bro, I know you're not chilling in my place without me. Get in. Spinelli let you in?
Yeah, man. Just make That's myself wild, at home. Man. Hey, well, it's good to see you too, man.
It's good to see you too,
yes,
man.
Sir.
Give me a heart attack. Bro, it's a good thing you're here, though. Sammy's been getting on my case like crazy, man.
About what?
Just about my work ethic. He's saying I'm not showing up on time or whatever. And, you know, sometimes it's true, but, you know, sometimes I get stuck in traffic, and you know what it is?
Oh, man.
He's telling me not to blow up on media, but then one day he just blows up on the media. It's like, how are you going to tell me not to do something and then you do it? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Nah, did Bron ever give you heat and stuff or something? That?
Yeah, a few times. A few times. But the most important thing is to be an individual. You take the good from the veterans and the people that have laid down the foundation before you, and then you take it and make it your own. But if he's getting you on your work ethic, something's got to be going on. You sure you're putting in every day? You sure you love this game dearly?
I do, man. What you?
I'm asking you. You got to know it. You got to feel it inside. I wake up every day knowing I'm blessed to play this game. I leave it all out there, man.
You really getting into it. Giving me that rookie advice, bro.
Well, I want you to survive in this league. You got some great talents. I feel like you can do big things.
I appreciate you, man, but I thought you just came over to chill and listen to some music.
Well, I did, man, but you wanted to get all serious,
get all sentimental. You were like, do you care for the game dearly, man? You look like you were going to cry, bro.
I wasn't going to cry, man. But on a side tip, you need to fire Spinelli. He didn't even ask me for my ID.
For real, man?
Man, hey,
DJ, it's wild.
I'm going to catch you later, man.
All right, bro, I'm going to catch you.
Hey, Shammy knows a good thing or two about this game of basketball. Open up your ears, man.
He probably paid you to say that.
Guys, I'm so excited to announce this. Basically, you guys know how I made the Boss Nation t-shirt, which was like a soccer jersey. Well, I went ahead and dropped my second shirt, which is an NFL jersey. All you have to do is come over to this kiosk, click on buy a shirt. Once you're here, you can either scroll down and look for it, or to make your life simple, just hit the search button and look up my gamer tag on Twitter Boss. This is only for Xbox One, unfortunately. But your boy made a Sean Taylor jersey. Dude, it took me some time to put this together. It was very simple, though. But I try to make it as, like, authentic as possible. You guys see the jersey tag is on the bottom right. I put, like, stitching patterns on the jersey. I made it look extra clean. So right now, it's up on the kiosk. You can go ahead and pick it up. I think it's like 3,500 VC. But there you guys see, I switched out from the Boss Nation into the Sean Taylor jersey. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, like I said, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Also, subscribe if you're new to the channel. Boss Nation, continue being amazing people. It's your boy, Onto the Boss. I am signing out.